With user authentication in place, we can now look at some more advanced use cases. Let's look into how we can restrict access to some pages only to users that are logged in, and also allow login only through a set of specific providers. And we can achieve both of these tasks by configuring routing and rules in Azure Static Web Apps. Similar to the previous video, we're going to go through a Learn module that focuses on configuring authentication providers and access. And the first thing that we want to do is add rules to the routing configuration file so we can disable some authentication providers. Then we want to secure the product list so only authenticated users can access it. We want to deploy the updated app and finally test that the restrictions are effective. And we'll update the routing configuration on our application to disable authentication with Azure Active Directory. And to do so, we need to go into our staticwebapps.config.json file. And usually this is available in the folder that we define to be app location. So in our case, that's React App. And I'm gonna go ahead and copy this code that defines what authentication providers we're disabling. So I'm going to paste it in our staticwebappconfig.json file. And what this tells us is that now whenever we try to access the auth login AAD path, it's going to return a 404, which is not found. And this is how we disable a pre-configured, enabled by default authentication provider. The next thing that we want to do is secure the product list access. So we want to only allow access to the product list to authenticated users. And we do that by defining a role within the allowed roles array for a particular route. So in this case, what we're saying is that in order to access API products, you need to be authenticated. So let's go ahead and push these changes to GitHub. And this will trigger a GitHub action to run that will deploy our new configuration. So if I go back to my GitHub repository, we can see that we now have a new GitHub action run that will build and deploy our code. So if we go to our static web app, we can see that I'm no longer logged in and I cannot see the list of products. If I try to go to Active Directory and log in with that provider, I can now see 404 not found, which is the error message that we configured in our static web apps configuration. And then if I go into GitHub and I attempt to log in, then it will display the list of products for us. Cool. So in this video, we've seen how we can restrict access to certain pages only to logged in users, as well as how we can disable some of the default authentication providers that are available in Azure Static Web Apps.